Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. It's again a great joy to meditate the Word of God with you. But today, I want to share with you something very different, trying to teach in the context. And yesterday at around 5:36 p.m., I was going through the BBC News app. So as I was going through some of the articles written there, one of the articles said like this: mapping the advance of Taliban in Afghanistan, mapping the advance of Taliban in Afghanistan. And we all know what is happening there in Afghanistan. At around yesterday 6 p.m., even the Afghan president, he left the country fearing bloodshed. So what is happening right now in Afghanistan is something that is really a troubling one. So yes, I think if you are a person who prays for the world, who prays for the different countries in the world, I would really ask you to pray for Afghanistan. And yesterday at around 6:30, Taliban even captured Kabul. So this particular article with the title "Mapping the Advance of Taliban in Afghanistan," it began like this. So this is what I want. I want to talk about. So the article began like this. Emboldened by the withdrawal of US troops, the Taliban's control all key cities and have closed in on the capital, Kabul. And when I read this article, I found a spiritual connection to it. Emboldened by the withdrawal of the United States, emboldened by the withdrawal of the US troops. So, Taliban's always wanted to have Afghanistan under their own control, but they couldn't control it because there were US troops. US was in control over that place. But the moment the US troops withdrew from there, the Taliban's captured the entire Afghanistan. That's what the author of that article, the reporter, starts like this: emboldened by the move of United States. I think that is sometimes very true even in our spiritual life. As long as the Lord is there in our lives, as long as God is there in our life. I'm not comparing US to God and Taliban to Satan, so please don't mistake me. I'm just trying to bring out a typological context here. So please don't think, I'm not saying US is God and Taliban are Satan. That's not what I mean here. What I'm trying to say is this: many at times, as long as God is there in our lives, the devil and his troops and his trickery has no control over us, because there is God in our lives. But the moment God takes a back seat, or the moment God leaves us, or we go away from God, the enemy tries to seize control. You know, that is what we read in two different biblical passages. Number one, in 1 Samuel chapter 16 and verse 14. 1 Samuel chapter 16 and verse 14. Now the Spirit of the Lord had departed from Saul, and an evil spirit tormented him. The moment the Spirit of God left Saul, an evil spirit started taking control of him. Again, we can see the same thing even in Samson's life in Judges chapter 16 and verse 20. He gets up, he woke from the sleep, and I thought, and I'll go out as before and shake myself free. He thought, I'll go out and do whatever I do regularly, but he did not know that the Lord had departed from him. And we know the story of Samson. When the Lord had left him, you know, his eyes was blinded, he was jailed, and a little boy was leading him. Emboldened by the move of the US troops withdrawing, emboldened by the withdrawal of US troops, the Taliban seized control. And I would say, in a spiritual context for our lives, emboldened by the move of God's Spirit leaving our lives, the devil tries to seize control. So I want to conclude today's thought with this. Do we have God in our lives? Do you have the Spirit of God in our lives? Because the moment God leaves us, or the moment we leave God, we naturally get into the enemy territory, and it is going to be tough for us. It's going to be tough for us. You know, even as we continue to pray for nations like Afghanistan, let us also analyze our lives and let us draw near to God. May God be with us and may God guide us through. Stay blessed. Amen. Amen.